You know, one of the best-selling books on stage hypnosis in the UK, and in America it's climbing as well, throughout the world, is happily one that I wrote myself called Deeper and Deeper. And in it I explain the difference between stage hypnosis and hypnotherapy. And that is that stage hypnosis is hypnosis done on stage as a form of entertainment, as a demonstration, and hypnosis done clinically, in clinical hypnotherapy, is hypnosis done to alleviate either the symptoms of the cause or the behavioural patterns of something that's erroneous and unwanted. But basically they're both the same state, or should be. And I probably said this in one of my other videos. I know it's a bit of a bugbear of mine, that hypnosis is hypnosis. There's no such thing as stage hypnosis. There's no such thing as clinical hypnosis, in as much as there is no such thing as track running or street running, in as much as it's running. So the big battle, the stage hypnosis versus hypnotherapy, clinical hypnotherapy battle, seems to have been raging to the outside world for a long time, because when you go on the websites you get lots of hypnotherapy sites that say don't do hypnotherapy, don't do stage hypnosis is bad, it's terrible, and it can probably make you blind. I have never yet, not once, have I gone to a stage hypnotist site who doesn't say anything bad about hypnotherapy. In fact, if you go to stage hypnotist sites, you'll see that most of them, the vast majority of them, do remedial hypnosis as well. They do therapy as well. The reason for that being is that a real hypnotist knows that there are many ways for their art to be used. I think it's a sad world where the number one style of hypnosis, stage hypnosis, that's seen by the outside world, the biggest advertisement that hypnosis has got for its potential, is seen as derogatory, and that's usually by hypnotherapists who are suffering from what I call client depletion. And they're suffering from client depletion, not because there's stage hypnotists around, but because they're bad business people, they're bad marketers, and they will blame everybody and anything on their failure. Sadly, that's the truth of it. The truth is that stage hypnosis, in actual fact, has never really harmed anybody to any point, with any proof anyway. No matter what myths you may have heard, nobody that we could find. In 1996 in the UK, the 1952 Hypnotism Act was reviewed. At that time they did a survey of over 12 countries looking for instances of reported damage and harm done to people by being hypnotized on stage. They did not find one single case, and this is a government survey, they did not find one single case of anybody falling off stage, breaking anything, of anybody being stuck in hypnosis or being paranoid or psychotic afterwards. In fact, what they found was 12 cases, and we're talking a 50-year period, and they found 12 cases of headache. Now, that can be stopped if you know what you're doing when you're a stage hypnotist, and if you come along to my masterclass, I'll tell you how that works. If you buy the book, I'll tell you how it works. Now, so I can't understand the battle between hypnotherapy and stage hypnosis, because as a stage hypnotist who's done lots and lots of off-stage work, I can't see the difference between the blessed things at all. And I think it's rather silly and puerile and juvenile to say that one is bad in either direction. Now, I've recorded lots of these. I've recorded 20 of these little videos, possibly even more, who knows. If you go along to learn-hypnosis.com, learn-hypnosis.com, and put down your email address, give me your first name, I'll send you the videos. You can look at them, you can use them to frighten children away from the fire, you can use them as wallpaper to keep your colleagues away from the computers at work. You can use them in any way you like. You can insult me as much as you like. You can approve me as much as you like. I like the approval bits. Get the other side. There's always two sides to any point of view, and maybe you ought to get the other side and see what happens. I'll give you those completely and absolutely free in return for your email address. We won't spam you. My name's Jonathan Chase, and I look forward to seeing you there.